WDMT, WDMT HD1 Pittston. Northeast PA's 102.3 The Mountain. Independent radio.
How you doing, people? This is Paul Stanley of Kiss, and Alan's not around. We're out rocking and rolling, but when he gets back in, he's going to call you. So leave your name, number, and a brief message. See ya.
Thank you again for the fine intro, Mr. Stanley. That is actually an answering machine message that Paul Stanley made for me in 1998. At that point, I had interviewed Kiss a couple of times, and I got to know the guys a little bit. And he was kind enough to do that for me. The funny part about it is that a lot of my friends would call my house hoping that I wouldn't be home, or calling in the afternoon when they knew that I would be at work, just so that they could hear the Paul Stanley answering machine greeting. That was actually, I think, maybe the third or fourth time I had interviewed Kiss. The first time I interviewed Paul was in 1994. And that was around the time of the Kiss My Ass tribute album. And it was an interesting time for the band because there were a lot of tribute bands that start playing in the bars, tributes to Kiss. A lot of critical acclaim start coming their way. Young bands start praising them as an influence. I talked to Paul about that in 1994.
The reason why we may be getting some better press today is because there's a changing of the guard. Because yesterday's fan of the band has become today's writer, today's journalist, today's musician. So that's why. It's not a coincidence that, you know, there's more people pointing to us. It's because they've, you know, there's been a coup, and they've taken over. We are not role models. We don't have the answer. You have the answer. Believing in yourself gives you the ability to climb any mountain.
Hey! I'm gonna burn the mountain.
calling Dr. Love here on 102.3 FM The Mountain. That's Kiss going back to 1977. That was on the Rock and Roll Over album originally. I played the version from Double Platinum. Just remixed a little bit. Got a little more groove to it. I always liked the little tweaks that they did to that one on the Double Platinum record. Before that, King of the Mountain from 1985 from the Asylum album. We're going to play a little segment of an interview I did here with Ace Frehley back in 1995. Ace came to the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre area twice in 95. He did a show at Tinks in Scranton. He did a show at the Woodlands in Wilkes-Barre. I got a chance to talk to him around that time. And I asked him what his favorite memory is of his time with Kiss. Now, at this point, he had not rejoined the group as he did in 96. So I'm sure if you asked him that question today, his answer might be a little different. It might be the big shows they did at Tiger Stadium to kick off the reunion tour or the four nights they did at the Garden. But in 1995, Australia was what came to mind when we talked to Mr. Frehley.
Trip to Australia was nice. 6 weeks of insanity. Well, we get to Australia and we were welcomed like the Beatles, you know, hitting America from the cover of the newspaper every day. Basically took the country by storm. That was probably the most amazing experience. And, you know, headlining three nights in that Square Garden. Yeah, it's my hometown.
I just can't pretend no more. I keep running out of life.
Kiss here on 102.3 FM, The Mountain, with Sure Know Something from 1979's Dynasty album. Of course, that was the same album that had the big hit I Was Made for Loving You included on the record. A departure for Kiss in many ways. A lot of people felt it had a little bit of a disco vibe to it. And I guess that's certainly a little bit of the case with I Was Made for Loving You. I remember Paul Stanley said at the time that I read an interview. He went to Studio 54 one night in New York City. And he said, man, if that's all it takes to get a song on the radio, I could write one of these songs in my sleep. And he went home that night and wrote I Was Made for Loving You. But other groups were doing it as well. The Rolling Stones certainly dabbled in that sound a little bit with their Some Girls record. I actually took a shot at Sure Know Something, the song. I recorded it for a charity album, Contra for a Cause 7, a couple of years ago, a big event that we used to do in the Wilkes-Barre area for charity. And Kiss helped out in that concert in a very nice way one year. I reached out to the group. I told them we were doing a concert for charity that was going to benefit children here in the area. And within a couple of days, Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley had sent an autographed guitar. A nice story about Kiss that maybe a lot of people weren't aware of that I thought I'd share tonight on the program. Before that, we heard Shandy from 1980's Unmasked album, a huge hit for the band in Australia. And before that, we heard Ace Frehley reminiscing a little bit about the Unmasked tour down under. We're going to keep the show rolling here, getting back to our current interview with Gene Simmons. Gene, obviously very excited about the new Monster album that's coming out in October, and how basically with this record, he feels that the band has rediscovered a new sound, which in a sense is their old sound.
Everybody in the band writes, and it feels like the Kiss that started, and not like some kind of modernized Kiss, like we've got to do tapping on guitar and do dive bombs and double kick, kind of fast up-tempo stuff. I mean, we've played around with a lot of stuff. And when you go to eat in a French restaurant, you know, once you appreciate the tons of butter they put in, the creams and everything, but you do that every day and you're going to throw up. Ultimately, there's nothing like mom's cooking, and that's just the way it is. You know, the basics, meat and potatoes. You can go out and try all sorts of stuff, and then you got to come home. You got to come home to who you are and what you do naturally, and stop pretending to be somebody you're not. And if you take the point of view of Popeye the Sailor Man, it is actually profoundly true. I am what I am, and that's all that I am. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Kind of a funny line, but it's actually pretty profound.
You can do it.
Kiss are on 102.3 FM The Mountain with Saint and Sinner from 1982's Creatures of the Night. Of course, that was the same record that featured I Love It Loud. It was also the last album that the band did wearing makeup for many years. About 14 years they went without it after that album. Probably the thing that people think about the most when they think about the Creatures of the Night album was the amazing drum sound that Eric Carr, the late Eric Carr, offered on that record. He really put his stamp on that record and sort of arrived as one of the premier drummers of the 80s. We're going to take a quick break now, but when we get back, we have a lot more of the Kiss on the Mountain radio special, so stick around. All right, we're back here on 102.3 FM The Mountain and the Kiss on the Mountain radio special. Back in 1994, I had the opportunity to interview original Kiss drummer Peter Criss, and I talked to him about some of his favorite memories of Kiss, and I thought that they probably would have been having a song like Beth, which he co-wrote and sang, become a top 10 hit, or maybe winning a People's Choice Award for the song. But his answer was something much more simple.
My fondest memories of having people carry my luggage. Being spoiled, being pampered. It's absolutely a luxury now, I know that. It's a true luxury to have some guy really carrying the luggage and set up your gear, man, you know, make life really easy for you. It's an unbelievable feeling to have your own Learjet and 85 guys working for you. So all you really have to do is go up and create the great gift that God gave us, and that's music. I mean, playing for 100,000, 200,000 people at a pop almost every other night sometimes is being the number one. It's the greatest feeling in the world.
If never I met you, I'd never have seen you cry. If not for a first hello, we never have to say goodbye. If never I held you, my feelings would never show. It's time I start walking, but there's so much you never know. Child of
I got a body built for sin and an appetite for passion.
We're going to queue up another one of the archive interviews that I did here with Kiss. This one's with Paul Stanley from 1998, and obviously with Kiss coming to town on Tuesday night with Motley Crue, everybody's excited about the show, and here Paul talks about the show.
We want to entertain, and entertain, you know, in capital letters. We're very proud to be entertainers. We're musicians, and we're a rock band. When we hit the stage, then it's time to take, you know, then you up the ante. Then it's just not about music. If you just want music, you buy a CD. If you want to see a show, that's really what you're doing. You're going to see a show, you know, with the emphasis on see, feel, hear. That's the school we come from. You know, we're all members of the audience. I remember too often being in the audience at a show and paying money that was hard to come by and often feeling either disappointed or disrespected by a band who seemed to forget that I put them on stage and I was paying for their car and their house. I take what I do seriously, and I'm not ashamed to say the ring that I'm in doesn't see many contenders.
Kiss here on 102.3 FM The Mountain with Cold Gin from 1974 from their debut album, a song that Ace Frehley said he quote-unquote wrote on the subway when I was a kid. How do I know that? Because he said it on stage at the West Side Theater in Scranton in 1985. Before that, Kiss with Love Her All I Can from 1975's Dressed to Kill. We're going to be taking a break now, but before we do, I want to remind everybody of the contest we have going on the website, 102themountain.com. We've got your opportunity there to win tickets to the Kiss show at Montage Mountain on Tuesday night, a chance to win backstage passes. We've got special limited edition Destroyer Resurrected copies on vinyl and CD, as well as the Kiss Icons double CD Greatest Hits package. So again, just go to the website, 102themountain.com, click on the Kiss link, make sure that you have your Mountain Community password with you, and the password for this week is Pyro, 102themountain.com. Get yourself backstage Tuesday night at Montage. We'll be back in a flash. All right, we're back around 102.3 FM The Mountain. This is the Kiss on the Mountain radio special, presented in part by The Weekender, one of our sponsors, which I appreciate. I'm going to play a snippet for an interview with you now that I did with Paul Stanley back in 2004 on the Rock the Nation tour. Kiss had done a farewell tour in 2000, and it wasn't long after that Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley began to have second thoughts about that, and they basically resurrected the band, kept the band going with Eric Singer and Tommy Thayer, who they've talked about a lot here on some of the interviews that we played tonight during the program. These are Paul Stanley's thoughts on the idea of Tommy and Eric wearing the same makeup as Ace Frehley and Peter Criss, which previously had always been presented as an extension of the individual members of Kiss's personalities.
Those original notions, ours or anyone else's, were a mistake, because the fact is that we've spent 30 years building Kiss into the icon that those images are. And you could take a picture of Kiss arguably anywhere in the world and people would know that it is in fact Kiss. They wouldn't be able necessarily to name all the members. And that's the point. Ultimately, the most important thing has always been Kiss. And Kiss is a tradition, a legend, and something that the public want in no uncertain terms. And I have to say that the band has never been better, both sounding-wise, look-wise. The set that we're playing and the flexibility we have now is amazing. I mean, and the crowd response, and I mean to the diehards, is fanatically positive. You know, people coming over after the show and saying, you know, this is by far the best I've ever seen the band and by far the best show I've ever seen.
Paul Stanley back in 2004 talking about the band's decision to continue on after the 2000 farewell tour, which obviously a lot of people are very happy about. If you've seen any of the pictures that the band has been posting on its Facebook page of the current tour with Motley Crue, the crowds have been enormous. I'm going to play one for you now here from 1985. This is from the Asylum album. I remember when this record came out, I read an interview with Paul in Kerrang! Magazine, and the interviewer said, "Hey, how come Radar for Love sounds so much like Black Dog?" And Paul Stanley said, "Because I love Led Zeppelin."